Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Cajun-style Hoppin John. Hoppin John is a dish that I make every year for New Year's Day. It's a Southern tradition, and the idea behind it is that if you eat Hoppin John on New Year's Day, you'll have good luck all year long. And we are superstitious enough that we have it, and we've had pretty good luck. Not that there is a real connection, but there is a Southern tradition that we like to follow. Hoppin John consists of rice and black-eyed peas. And this has to be done in some kind of a skillet or a casserole, but I like to add different things to it. So when I do my rice, which I'm going to prepare in just a minute, I've decided to make brown rice, which is not really typical, but it's healthier, and we decided to do that. It takes a little bit longer to cook, so we're putting brown rice in. I usually add something like bacon or maybe ham. This year, I'm adding andouille sausage, and that's why I refer to it as Cajun style. I'll be putting some Cajun seasoning in, and I'll have some vegetables. But we'll get all of that in just a minute. Right now, we're going to do the thing that takes the longest, and that's the rice, because it's brown rice. It would take about half as long with white rice. I have opened a can of beef consomme. That's a 10.75-ounce soup can. And you can see I've already emptied the broth into here. And I have another can just like that. Beef consomme, or you could use beef broth or beef bouillon, and just use two cans, then fill one can with up to the level that it was with brown rice and put that in. So the proportion here is two cans of some type of beef broth to one can of rice, whether you use white rice or brown rice. So we'll stir that together. And then we're going to put 1 tablespoon of butter in with it. We're not going to salt it because the broth itself is salty. 1 tablespoon of butter. And we're going to take this to the stove and bring it to a boil. When it comes to a boil, I'm going to put a lid that fits on top. And then it takes about 35 to 40 minutes. And you don't lift the lid during that time. But I will check it at the end of 40 minutes and it should be done. So to the stove and let it come to a boil. Here we have our beef broth and brown rice and the butter, and it's come to a rolling boil. I'm going to stir it just to get that butter incorporated. And then I'm going to reduce the heat down to medium or even low. Just a comfortable simmer. And then I'm going to put my lid on, and then I'll be setting a timer in just a minute, so I will know that when 35 or 40 minutes have passed. Now that I have my rice on the stove, I'm going to work on my andouille sausage. It comes in a pack like this with two of these in here. I've already taken one of them out, which was identical to this, and I have prepared it by cutting it into circles or coins. And all you have to do here is just use scissors to get into your packet. And there is no casing that has to be removed because it was packed like that. But you do need to separate this in whatever way you like, but I just like to make about 1/4 inch cuts. So I'll be working on that for a minute. I'm just finishing up with my coins of andouille sausage. What I plan to do is put them in a deep skillet. So I have my deep skillet here, and I'm going to take this to the stove and brown these up. And there will be some grease that comes out, more than likely, and I will drain that off when I come back. Here we have 13.5 ounces, and I think that's just about the right amount for 2 cans of black-eyed peas, which we'll be introducing later, plus the rice that we have prepared and the vegetables we're going to be sauteing in just a minute. But this goes to the stove and gets browned up until it's a little bit browner on the edges and nice and juicy. These have been cooking for probably between 5 and 10 minutes. And you can see they're getting nice and crusty and brown. It's time to turn this off. And then I'm going to lift these out into a little bowl. I'm putting some paper toweling in there to absorb any excess grease. And there will be grease, a little bit, left in the skillet. And I'm going to drain that out and wipe it dry with paper toweling. Here's our browned up andouille sausage. And I'm just patting it so it gets all of the extra grease out of it. Andouille sausage is smoked pork sausage, and this has a little bit of beef in it as well and some spices. So we're gonna just set that aside until we need it. And then you can see the rice is simmering along as it should. And we're coming over to the skillet that I used, and I've wiped it out so that it is free of any of the grease. That's 2 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil. And to that, I'm adding some vegetables. I have 1/2 cup chopped celery. I have 1/2 cup chopped green bell pepper. And 1/2 cup chopped onion. Now I'm going to stir these and let them saute until they're softened. And right toward the end, I'll be adding 2 cloves of garlic, which are minced. So when I come back, all of this will be softened, ready to move on. Here we have our softened vegetables, and to this I'm going to add some Cajun seasoning. It's labeled Cajun seasoning, but there are other labels that will work as long as it has a blend of something like it says salt and red pepper and garlic and some other spices. And if you don't have the Cajun seasoning, then you could just use some of those spices in the proportion that you like. But I have 1 teaspoon that I've measured out here that I'm going to put over my softened vegetables and stir that in. Next, I'm returning the andouille sausage back to the skillet, and it should be pretty free of grease. And here's where our black eyed peas come in. We have 2 standard size cans. Usually those are 14 and a half ounces, something like that. Don't drain them. Just go ahead and put the entire can in, and there are 2 of them here. Any brand that you like. I use Bush's, and it says black eye peas. Sometimes it says black eyed, same thing. Now I'm gonna stir this around and then take this back to the stove and let it just simmer long enough to get all the flavors combined. And by that time, the rice will probably be done and we can put it all together. This may take as much as 20 minutes. My brown rice is done and I'm adding the last of it to my andouille sausage and black eyed pea mixture. I did taste the rice to make sure that it was not crunchy or hard. It's absolutely done. I did taste the mixture of andouille sausage and the vegetables and the black eyed peas. In both cases, they were well salted, so I did not add any salt. So I think it's going to be fine for you just like this. And you may use as much or as little of the rice as you like. It will make about twice as much as what you see when you first put it in the pot. So I'm going to stir this around and then serve it into a dish. I want to take a bite of our Cajun-style Hopping John for you. And what I have here is a soup spoon to eat it with. And I've got together my bread, which I like to serve it with French bread or Italian bread. This is sort of a sweet Italian bread, which is a nice contrast to the hot and peppery flavor of the Cajun version of Hoppin John. And then for a drink, I have some green tea. I thought that would be good and refreshing as well. Now this is really hot. It just came out of that skillet, so I'm going to judiciously load my spoon. I want to get some of the andouille sausage, also some black-eyed peas, and then that mixture of vegetables. All of that should go in here. So let's see what it tastes like. It's hot. It tastes really good. It's not hot in the sense of being really peppery, spicy, can't take it hot. There is an element of heat. But I think it's just right. But I definitely can pick up on the Cajun spices in there and the andouille. So I hope you enjoy this recipe. It's something a little different because it's for New Year's Day. It is generally served on New Year's Day. It could be breakfast, lunch, or dinner. But it provides you with good luck the whole year long. So I hope you have a wonderful 2015. And I wish you a very happy New Year's Day.